Totally,
yeah, of course.
That part we knew. Is anybody hungry? Let's go get some pizza.
Well... thanks.
You're welcome.
Oh, so you can't talk.
Yeah.
So that was the summer that David taught me the greatest lesson in life, that love conquers all, even your greatest fear. Mr. Goodfarer never found out I launched his rocket, but it didn't matter because his blueprints were America's future in space, not the model of the shuttle. Goliath and Tiny had 5 puppies. Haley, Jenny, and Penny each got one for their own. Mr. Myrtle kept 2 of them. The retriever made peace with his inner demons. His family moved to Australia, and he grew up to be the host of a popular Animal Planet television show.
Hey, you wouldn't know anything about a kid in this neighborhood goes around stealing dog tags, would you?
No, sir. Oh, I think I hear my mom calling me.
I kept in touch with most everyone over the years, and I found out that Mac joined the Army after high school. He got wounded in the Gulf War, won a Purple Heart, and joined the Peace Corps. Fingers and his brother Saul started a record label for a new kind of music called hip-hop. They named their company Def Jam Records. Penny and Jenny never did anything more remarkable than the most difficult thing on earth. They both raised 3 kids and lived happily ever after with their families. With the fortune he made in the music business, Fingers started the most successful gum company on earth. You know it as Kissing Booth Bubblegum. Tarkel, well, Tarkel was abducted by aliens on March 21st, 1986, and no one ever saw him again. Haley became a supermodel and a pitcher for the United States Olympic softball team. She won 2 gold medals. After David defeated Goliath, he got a nickname. From then on, he was known as David Rocket Durango. Haley and David went all the way through high school together. After that, they went their separate ways. 10 years after college, they met again. At that meeting, just like the first time he had ever had a chance to talk to her in grade school, David was so nervous, he couldn't speak. So she spoke for him, and she said, "You're supposed to say, will you marry me?" And he did. Oh, I almost forgot. I grew up and went to work for the Jet Propulsion Laboratories. Hey, rockets are still my life.